Source maps are critical for web development in today's JavaScript environment. In fact, all of our build tools, Rollup, Vite, Webpack, ESBuild, they transpile and bundle our JavaScript and support source maps right out of the box. Because debugging errors in production with transpiled code is now impossible, so our tooling creates source maps. Source maps are literally just JSON files with line references. Each line in the source code is mapped to a character in the transpiled code. This enables our tooling, in particular Chrome DevTools, to show us our source code lines in the stack traces, and lets us use our source code in the debugger as well. But fully public source code has traditionally made companies nervous, so source maps have mostly been used on staging servers. They've also been shipped to monitoring services like Highlight, Sentry, and Datadog. This lets the monitoring services display raw source code and stack traces as well. Private source maps do make it harder for an attacker to understand your front-end application. An attacker can easily use public source maps to view the code in its original untranspiled state. The same source maps that make debugging easier make attacking your application easier. Check out our unobfuscated source code on highlight.io. It's readable, public, and easy to ingest for developer tools. Our Vite bundler generates these source maps with a single flag. Any attacker can read our source code. But guess what? With or without source maps, Chrome DevTools makes deconstructing your JavaScript application relatively easy. For instance, you can open up the network tab and watch each request and response. The application tab also surfaces the data your site is saving locally. Who cares about how the code is written if the results in both data and network are readily visible? DevTools will even allow an attacker to reformat minified code and use breakpoints to step through it. And then there's ChatGPT. ChatGPT struggles with long code snippets, so it's not yet a silver bullet for decompilation. But ChatGPT can decompile shorter code snippets quite effectively. So what's the upside of public source maps? First off, DevTools will automatically recognize and apply public source maps to your code. Debugging production issues will be much, much easier, especially if you see errors in your console. With public source maps, DevTools can link your errors directly to the decompiled code. It's magical. The product I'm building, Highlight, does support private source maps. We even publish a source map uploader on NPM that will send your private source maps directly to our servers. Our source map uploader works well, but depending on a team's setup, it can be tricky for users to implement and can become a constant source of bugs due to unique build pipelines and machine types. However, if you make your source maps public, you don't have to do any of that work, and you automatically get production source maps for your own debugging and dev tools. It's a win-win.